What's happening, YouTube? What's happening out there, people? It's your main man AI coming to you live on behalf of the Gamers Federation Radio. And I wanted to talk about co-op in gaming today. Yes, co-op in gaming. I don't want to say lost art in gaming today, but co-op has definitely seen a decline or been very undervalued in its usage. In a lot of games today, I think co-op has been co-opted for things like multiplayer and stuff of the like, which is not a bad business model, but I think a lot of games could benefit a lot from using the co-op business model. I mean, if you think about it, let's say back in the day when Capcom and Japan first came out with, you know, beat 'em ups and co-op gaming a la Karate Kid, Kung Fu, Battletoads, Contra, Streets of Rage, you know, games of the like, which is more along the beat 'em up and adventure style games. But they had a certain co-op to them. I remember back in the day where, you know, you used to go over to a friend's house and there used to be a lot of you guys kind of gathered around. The main thing would be, you know, let's get on Ninja Turtles, or let's get on some four-player game, or if you went to the arcade, you get on something like X-Men, The Simpsons, I just said Ninja Turtles arcade game, Sunset Riders, and games like that. And you guys would all go in an adventure together, you know, stuff like, you know, Golden Axe, Gauntlet Legends. You go on an adventure together, and everybody has some type of role to play, or some type of specific job. And you kind of see that in some sense in today's MMOs, but they kind of really phase out the specifics of different personality amongst different characters. And what you're left with is usually just customizing your own specific type of character that kind of is similar to everybody else's. But back to the co-op thing, I think a lot of games should definitely start experimenting with co-op, especially like RPGs. And it's really quite sad because the role-playing genre itself does not utilize co-op enough. I mean, a lot of games, let's say JRPGs, had New Game Plus, but not too many games really showcased, hey, here's another co-op campaign when you and a buddy, especially back in the 90s and early 2000s when PlayStation was dominated. Nobody was like, hey, you guys, let's play. I mean, you guys could do a co-op mission together and you can combine your story with his story and you guys have a thoroughly different story, if I could say. I'm trying to get my words in, I'm sorry. I mean, yes, you could say something like the Tales series, they let you do co-op in gaming. You get to play with your own character, but from a story perspective, I mean, wouldn't it be nice to have your friend or your buddy? And nowadays we got online capabilities, your friend or your buddy somewhere, you know, locally or across state lines. You could play with them or random people. You could play with, do missions and stuff together that are actually relevant to the story. So even shooters, like take like a Call of Duty, for instance, even something like a Call of Duty could benefit tremendously from something like co-op. I mean, think about it. You have your, you know, dual co-op, you have your specific squad. And I know games like Counter-Strike and, you know, team-based squadrons type games probably already do this. But if you have a campaign like a Call of Duty or a Battlefield and you get to do that with friends together, you know, they kind of build a story around a group of people, I think that would be a larger selling point. And in the other genres, such as, you know, adventure platform games where you have to use like teamwork, imagine something like a Metroidvania style game or a Metroid. Imagine just a Metroid with another hunter. You know, you go into the future, something, you get two hunters and y'all start on different sides of the map, a huge map. And or you have different hunters as the sense of everybody has different power-ups, right? So you have to utilize everybody's skill or, you know, specific skill to clear levels, beat bosses, you know, stuff of the like. Because nowadays, everybody can use pretty much use the same weapon. I think Destiny is really trying to take that whole multiplayer co-op thing to the next level, where you know you get to play as a hunter or a titan, and what's the other one called? A hunter or a titan? I forget the other one. Warlock. I'm sorry, a warlock, and you guys get to go at it on bosses and stuff like that. Now, if everyone, if a lot of companies would adopt that methodology, I think you will see more sales, you know, especially in our, you know, side scrollers and adventure style games. Even MMOs might do a whole lot better if they were more like, I don't want to say team based, because they have a lot of team based games, but if it was just more applicable to more people. But yeah, co-opting games, even something like a GTA co-op, right? I mean, they have multiplayer, but I mean, you don't really have missions. I may be incorrect. Or something like a Watch Dogs, Infamous maybe, where, you know, everybody has different missions and you come at it as co-op story. I just think that in today's timing, we should be able to write for different experiences. And you don't even have to be super in depth. Only thing you have to really be in depth is with your, with the characters and making them personable, and people can relate to them, and your games can kind of appeal emotionally to people. And I mean, I really don't think it's too hard, but what do you guys out there think? Do you think co-op is underutilized in gaming today? Can we do a lot more with co-op gaming? I mean, if you think about stuff like just StarCraft and all the different type of mods the PC crowd adheres to, I don't think it's totally unfathomable I don't think it's totally unfathomable that I don't think it's you know, out of ordinary for us to do that. But I think that's it for this video. I want you guys to kind of leave your comments below, let me know what you guys think. And the game I'm playing, by the way, is Strider Hero. I got that free using the PlayStation Plus membership, and I, you know, I love Strider. I love the story, and I'm really enjoying this game. This game is pretty deep, and I think I put in one video to try this game out, especially if you have a PS4. And I think it's also on Steam. It's probably been on Steam since early on in the year. Definitely get this game and support this game. Double Helix made it, and they did a fantastic job on recreating Strider for the new audience, for those that are not familiar. But it's been my time. I'm AI, you know, part of the Golden Age Gamer crew. And I want to say appreciate you guys for listening to me, and stay tuned. Peace. I also forgot to mention, I was thinking, like, what if they had a co-op Pokemon? A co-op Pokemon. Just ponder that thought. But like I said, I'm AI. I just had to put that in real quick. And I'm out.